you record a PowerPoint presentation with the Camtasia add-in, chapter markers are created for every slide automatically. You can see this information by clicking the Show Marker or Quiz button on the timeline. You can change the marker's name in the Properties panel by clicking on specific markers. You can also delete them, drag them along your media, and create new markers by dragging the blue plus sign that appears when you drag your cursor along the timeline. These markers can be used to create an interactive table of contents with options you can adjust during the exporting process. To view interactive videos made by Camtasia, they must be viewed by the TechSmith Smart Player, though you can also create a SCORM file that can be uploaded to your Canvas page, which will be shown at the end of this video. Quizzes are a fun way to engage your students with the content of the video, as well as receive a limited quiz summary report at the end of each day. Create a quiz, click Interactivity in the tools bar. Here you can choose to add a quiz to the timeline or a specific piece of media. The quiz icon will appear where your playhead is. You can move the quiz along the timeline or on your specific media. You can add more quizzes by clicking the green plus sign in your timeline. You make your changes to the quiz in the Properties panel, starting with type, which are multiple choice, fill in the blank, short answer, or true or false. Type your question in the space provided. I'm using the question, what additional online tool does the Center for Teaching and Learning recommend to create interactive content to engage your students? For multiple choice, you can write in any amount of answers to choose from. Be sure to click the dot next to the correct answer, in this case, H5P. To give immediate feedback to your viewer, click Display Feedback. Type in the message for a correct answer and choose one of four actions. Continue the video, link to a website, or jump to a specific time or marker in your video. You can do the same for an incorrect answer. Fill in the blank and true or false quizzes can give feedback. The short answer quiz will send the results to your email. By clicking the white button in the top left of your Properties panel, you can see what the quiz will look like to your viewers. The last interactive feature is Interactive Hotspot, found in Visual Effects. This feature allows you to link to a web page, pause, or jump to a point in time in your video. To create, drag the interactive hotspot to a piece of media on the timeline. You can use your own media or a callout by going to Annotations, Shapes, and dragging a shape to the timeline. Adjust the time and size, then drag the hotspot onto the shape, and in the Properties panel, choose how viewers will interact. This hotspot will be directed to the H5P tool on the Center for Teaching and Learning website. Copy the URL and paste the link in the appropriate box. Checking the Open in New Browser tab will launch the viewer to the website. Place a callout text into the shape to give instructions. To produce your interactive video, click Export, Local File, Custom Production Settings, and Next. Select MP4 Smart Player HTML5. You must choose a Smart Player option to create an interactive video, then click Next. Choose your video settings, click Next. Fill out your video info, and click Next. Here you can select your table of contents options and click Next. Now you can choose if you want your quiz report sent to you through email and choose if you want a SCORM file created and its options. A SCORM file is needed to upload your video to Canvas. Otherwise, you will need to use the TechSmith Player through their website. Your produced MP4 file will not be interactive. Click Next to finish producing your video. To upload your video to Canvas, go to your Canvas course and click SCORM. Click the blue Upload button and locate the compressed zip file and click Open. After a few moments, your video will be ready to view and share with your class.